Bosses at South Tyneside Arts Venue say they are relieved after being awarded a £255,000 lifeline amidst the coronavirus pandemic. The Customs House in South Shields is one of the hundreds of organisations to benefit from the government's Culture Recovery Fund.
Relieved and delighted to actually get the £255,000, which sounds a huge amount of money, and I'd love it to be in my back pocket. But in fact, when you look at what it'll cover, it'll keep the organisation open and trading until the 1st of April, and then hopefully there'll be a brave new world out there. But it gives us a surety that the staff that remain, because some staff have been made redundant, the staff that remain will be able to be paid, and all our suppliers will be met by that fund until the 1st of April. And hopefully it'll give us an opportunity to springboard into spring 2021, when we'll be able to start programming things again.
The investment will help save 24 theatres, galleries, museums and local venues within the region. But is there still worries for the financial recovery for the arts?
I think what was a real concern to us as an organisation is there wasn't a clear steer as to how a place that's used to earning 92% of its income suddenly couldn't earn any of it, and how that would impact on not just us and we who are employed directly by Customs House Trust, but all of the freelancers who work with us. All of the acts that come here are in fact freelancers, and all the people who design our pantomime and our costumes and our set and do the lighting are all freelancers. So how was it going to impact on them? And certainly that part of the sector, the freelance sector, on which we rely so heavily, was overlooked by the government. Eventually they came on board with this recovery fund for venues, but there's a lot of freelancers out there who really, really struggled during this time.